Good morning. I'm Donna Hester, pastor at Kern Memorial United Methodist Church in Oak Ridge, Tennessee, and I want to welcome you this morning as you join us to worship our risen Savior. If you are in the Oak Ridge area and if you are a part of Kern, I have a couple of announcements for you. Just a reminder, with the change of mask policy, that we are in the red zone with the Harvard metrics. So please wear a mask when you are in the building for any activities. Also, Wednesday night at 6:30 on the church lawn, there will be an ice cream social. Ice cream cups and prepackaged toppings will be provided. If you would like to make your RSVP for this activity, please contact Alicia or Shanda at Alicia B or Shanda K at kernumc.org, and bring your chair for ice cream and a prayer. Let us praise our risen Lord.
Because of you, I freely live. my life to you. Oh God, I give, so I stand before you, God. I lift my voice, 'cause you set me free. So I shout out your name. From the rooftops I proclaim that I am yours. I am yours. All the good you've done for me, I lift up my hands for all to see. You're the only one who brings me to my knees. To share this love across the earth, the beauty of your holy worth. So I kneel before you, God. I lift my hands, 'cause you set me free. So I shout out your name. From the rooftops I proclaim that I am yours. I am yours. And all that I am, I place into your loving hands. And I am yours. I am yours. Here I am, I stand with arms wide open to the one, the Son, the everlasting God. The everlasting God. Here I am, I stand with arms wide open to the one, the Son, the everlasting God. The everlasting God. So I shout out your name. From the rooftops I proclaim that I am yours. Son, the everlasting God, the everlasting God.
Let us pray. Everlasting God, we enter into your presence today, and we enter with praise. We enter with thanksgiving. We enter with joy, recognizing all the ways in which you are around us, all the ways in which you care for us, all the ways in which you support us. And as we come into your presence in prayer, we come offering our prayers for our world. We offer our prayers for the areas of war, for the natural disasters, for all the people and nations and places that need your peace, your restoration, your presence. We offer our prayers for the sick, and we pray for your healing and your wholeness to come to all in need. We offer prayers for those who grieve this day, that your comfort might surround them. And with all that's going on around us, we pray for those who are anxious, for those who are having difficulties, and we pray for your strength. May your strength guide them and direct them. For all of our prayers we offer to you, and especially now we offer the prayer Jesus taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. As we come offering our tithes, our gifts, and our offerings, we come offering them in many different ways. Through our qualified charitable distributions from IRAs and stocks, electronic funds giving, the drop slide in the narthex door, or through the mail. All of those are ways in which we offer our tithes and our gifts, and ways in which we partner in the kingdom of God. Today I want to call your attention to a couple of special offerings. One, this is a fifth Sunday, so today is one of the most important days of the year for Holston Home. Our generous offerings bring hope and a brighter future to the children and their families, and we help to continue the mission of Holston Home to bring help and healing to children and families who struggle with life's challenges. Our generous gifts help change lives for tomorrow. Also, UMCOR offerings for Haiti, for hurricanes, and also for the flooding in Middle Tennessee are ways in which we offer our gifts. And UMCOR is one of the first to enter an area, one of the last to leave. And you can be assured that every dollar that you give goes for the disaster for which you give, as the special UMCOR offering in the spring pays for all administrative costs. Let all who desire to serve the Lord in sincerity and faithfulness bring their gifts with joyful hearts.
God, from whom all blessings flow, praise Him, all creatures here below, praise Him above, ye heavenly host, praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen.
Let us pray. Gracious God, we give you thanks for all that you have given to us, and we offer these our gifts to you. We offer them for your blessing. We offer them for your use. We offer them to help the children, that they might have a brighter future tomorrow. We offer them for restoration and ways in which you calm the storms around us as well as the storms of life. Accept these gifts, O God. Amen.
which God supplies through His eternal Son. Strong in the Lord of hosts and in His mighty power, who in the strength of Jesus trusts is more than conqueror. Stand then in His great might, stand entire at last. Pray without ceasing, pray. Your captain gives the word. His summons cheerfully obey and call upon the Lord. To God your every want in instant prayer display. Strength to strength go on, wrestle and fight and pray. Tread all the powers of darkness down and win the well-fought day. Still let the Spirit cry in all His soldiers come, till Christ the Lord descends from and takes the conquerors home.
Our gospel lesson this morning is actually not from the gospel this morning. It's from the New Testament. And it's the letter to the Ephesians, chapter 6, verses 10 through 20. And I'm reading from the Common English Bible. Finally, be strengthened by the Lord and His powerful strength. Put on God's armor so that you can make a stand against the tricks of the devil. We aren't fighting against human enemies, but against rulers, authorities, forces of cosmic darkness, and spiritual powers of evil in the heavens. Therefore, pick up the full armor of God so that you can stand your ground on the evil day and after you have done everything possible to still stand. So stand with the belt of truth around your waist, justice as your breastplate, and put shoes on your feet so that you are ready to spread the good news of peace. Above all, carry the shield of faith so that you can extinguish the flaming arrows of the evil one. Take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is God's word. Offer prayers and petitions in the Spirit all the time. Stay alert by hanging in there and praying for all believers. As for me, pray that when I open my mouth, I'll get a message that confidently makes this secret plan of the gospel known. I'm an ambassador in chains for the sake of the gospel. Pray so that the Lord will give me the confidence to say what I have to say. This is the word of God for us, the people of God. Thanks be to God. Paul is writing to the Ephesians. Paul is writing from jail to the Ephesians. And as Paul writes, as Paul explains how the Ephesians should be ready to fight the spiritual forces of wickedness, Paul uses an image of one he knows well. Paul uses an image of the soldier. Most likely, the image of those soldiers that have been with him. The soldiers he's been shackled to make sure that he remains in prison. And so out of that attire, Paul writes this message. We've heard the message before. We've heard the message in terms of ways in which we empower ourselves in God's grace, salvation, and mercy. Maybe you could call it a dress for success. We've heard those words a lot. I remember many years ago, as I was about to graduate from college, there was a special class we took, a class for interviewing skills. And one of those skills was a dress for success. And you still see it around today. For the men in the class, a navy or gray suit, a white long-sleeved dress shirt, a conservative silk tie with colors that enhance the suit, and a must. The shoes and belt must always match. For the women in the class, a navy or gray skirted suit, white cotton silk or blouse, and low-heeled shoes. And the skirt must be the length just below the knee. Dress for success. Sometimes that shifts depending on where we are and what we're doing. Dress for success as a fan means that you need to wear your appropriate team colors, whether they're blue, red, orange, black, purple. Dressing for success in the company may mean a certain attire, a shirt with the logo, and a khaki pants. Dress for success comes in so many ways, varying ways. As an athlete, dressing for success might be shin pads, cleats, a helmet. Dress for success. And Paul talks about dressing for success in the ways in which we are able to push away the forces of evil. Wickedness should not be around us. Dress for success. One way we look at that is with baptism. And if you're in the United Methodist Church, if you have taken baptismal confirmation or membership vows, you have heard these words. On behalf of the whole church, I ask you, do you renounce the spiritual forces of wickedness? Reject the evil powers of this world and repent of your sin. Do you accept the freedom and power God gives you to resist evil, injustice, and oppression in whatever forms they present themselves? Or, if you have renewed your vows or been a part of any baptism in the church, you have heard this question. Do you, as Christ's body, the church, reaffirm both your rejection of sin and your commitment to Christ? do you reject the evil forces of wickedness? Do you reject sin? Do you follow your commitment to Christ? And Paul would say there's a way to dress for this. Dress for success. And to dress for success, you go to the wardrobe. You pull out the belt of truth. And as you put that on, you think about the truthfulness and honesty and how they hold everything together securely. Paul also said there was a breastplate of righteousness. Righteousness is doing what is right and good in God's sight. We listen to the Holy Spirit in our hearts, and the Holy Spirit gives us the courage to do the right thing. Put on the shoes of the good news and peace. Make ready to proclaim the gospel of peace, the good news of Jesus. Be prepared to go and walk and to speak the peace and the truth and to give a peaceful word to the people. And then to have the shield of faith. Faith is a strong shield that we hold and we move. Faith deflects the fiery messages of doubt and unbelief. The doubt and unbelief bounce off, fizzle out, and don't get through us with our shield of faith. And then there's the helmet of salvation. Salvation is knowing in our mind that Jesus is our Savior. We remember that we can count on His faithfulness because He has already saved us. And finally, take up the sword of the Spirit of God's Word. God's word cuts through the lies and gives us wisdom. Dress for spiritual success by putting on your helmet, your breastplate, your belt, your shield, and your sword. That's what Paul talks about. Now, how often do we get up in the morning and put on our armor of God? I know. You're thinking, if that's what I'm going to look like, forget it. If that's spiritual success, forget it. I want no part of it. And I'll admit, it might be a little ridiculous. But as ridiculous as it is, tomorrow morning when you get out of bed, you might think about what you need to put on, how you need to be ready to go out, to face the spiritual forces of wickedness. Now, this is not the way we typically put on our armor of God. And while Paul used the soldiers around him as a guide, Paul goes on, and Paul tells us words that we definitely need to hear. Words that we need to remember. As Paul tells us to offer our prayers and petitions in the Spirit all the time. Stay alert by hanging in there and praying for all believers. You see, those questions that we are asked as we look at our lives and as our lives of baptism, when we put on the armor of God, we put on our defenses that we might reject sin and we might commit to God. That's what we are called to do. That's what Paul wants to remind us to do. The spiritual forces of wickedness are all around us. They're everywhere we go. But if we reject sin, if we commit to Jesus, if we pray and pray fervently that we might be able to go forth to share that peace and that good news and that truth that surrounds us, that we not only are rejecting sin and committing to Christ, we are also promoting and sharing and helping others to do the same. Dress for spiritual success. You don't have to look like this, but you do have to pray. You do have to have constant contact with God that you might be a part of sharing the peace and the news of His love and grace. Let us pray. We come to You, O God. We come knowing that You provide what we need to live. You call us to be brave Christians. Help us. Help us every day to trust You, to trust Your power. And thank You for sending Your Son and Your Spirit to keep us alert, to help us, and to guide us as we pray for others. Amen.
Your love is like radiant diamonds bursting inside us. We cannot contain. Your love will surely confine us like blazing wildfires, singing Your name. Your love is like radiant diamonds bursting inside us. We cannot contain. Your love will surely confine us like blazing wildfires, singing Your name. God of mercy, sweet love of mine, I have surrendered to Your design. May this all stretch across the sky, and these hallelujahs be multiplied. These hallelujahs be multiplied.
Receive now this blessing. The blessing of God who delivers us, the grace of Christ who sustains us, and the communion of the Spirit who empowers us, be with you always. Amen.